still with us, you know, in Houston, Texas. He is a trumpet player. And when I was 9 years old, you know, I mean, he was in a band, you know, and his drummer couldn't make it to the show. And so he begged my dad to let me play, you know, I was 9 years old. And, you know, my dad was totally against it because I was going to be, you know, in a bar. And then my uncle told my dad, you know, so they kind of changed it. So it was my uncle that kind of got me involved in the music business. And you know, to be real honest with you, you know, at first I have to say when I was growing up that money was the big factor. You know, cash. You know, I was 9 years old. I was clueless. But you know, I didn't have the responsibility. Obviously, you know, my parents, you know, kind of sheltered me, you know, from a lot of things. But they always kept on saying that we always want you to do something that makes you happy. And this is what made me ill. Trust me, I've done lots of things in my 59 years of existence. So the music has always been the thing that motivates me, and makes me happy, and it obviously makes a lot of it. Yes, sir.
What's y'all's plans for the break? Y'all have any further?
You know, everybody usually has a side project they want to get done, or you know, some songwriting, or maybe hang out with our wives for a while. Or they could be adamant about that.
Especially after 20.
You spend more time with Southern than you do with me.
This is true, but yes, sir.
I was wondering how you initiate. When you're on stage, you have a lot of pretty long songs. Do y'all ever take the initiative to end the song? How do you communicate that?
Yeah.
I need to know.
Close the door,
yeah. That's always a big struggle because, you know, for us, I mean, at least, you know, when I started the band, you know, we were always segueing into from one song to another.
Right.
To where there, for a point, we were going like, end the song because we never ended before, so we would always segue into another song.
That actually still happens to this very day. It's like, man, we've never ended that song, so I don't know.
And when we're in the studio, whether it's John Keane or Terry Manning or Jerry Sand, you know, he's always going like, well, you guys are going to end it. Of course, the beat in the studio is just totally different, you know, because you're in a sterile environment, you know, you're pretty much locked up, you know, and you're in there for 8 to 12 hours, really trying to do something that you're normally doing in front of, you know, whether it's 500 people or 5 people, you got like feedback from the audience, so you got to capture that moment right there.
Are there any particular steps I'll take
to
put together a set list from show to show?
Yeah, the set list gets agonized a lot these days because the thing is, we have a part for people to come out and see shows and styles of, and we really want to try to get them something. You know, every show's different, but within that, we try to dig out songs we haven't played in years, just something, anything to shake it up and not go on autopilot, because that's the last thing we want to do. The reason we started doing a set list in the first place was, once we had over 150 songs, it was just mentally to keep them all in our minds. And I remember I looked at a tally sheet one year and I started Please 100 times that year. You know, whoever starts the song starts it. And that's why I started thinking about it. I'm like, well, I'm just doing the same thing over and over too much. So then we sit down and started, you know, doing the list. We've got it. We've got like 350 songs to work on. So, you know, like I said, we try to give somebody something they haven't seen or heard in a while. Something.
What's your favorite guest artist that you've
seen? Herbie Hancock.
Carlos Santana.